5-axis machines are growing in popularity and demand today. But how much do you really know about 5-axis machine performance? One of the most important things is the rotary gear transmission system. Many people are still not clear about this system. Different manufacturers use different terminology, and this confuses many buyers, so it is hard for them to compare and make a fair judgment. The types of rotary transmission are different in every 5-axis machine, and you need to know what to expect from the performance of the transmission and which type is most suitable for your machining needs before buying a 5-axis machine. There are three main types of rotary transmission: cycloidal gears, direct servo motor drives, worm gears, cycloidal gears. Cycloidal gears are a transmission system that uses cycloidal discs that roll along a set of pins. They take advantage of cycloidal curves to minimize friction, making it more reliable. It has a rugged and durable design. Multiple contact points help with load distribution between the gear teeth and give it a very high resistance to shock loads. It has smooth acceleration and deceleration, which means it has very little backlash. Paired with rotary scales, it has almost zero backlash and is very accurate for 5-axis indexing. Its high gear ratios give it more power, and its low starting torque gives it faster indexing speeds and a smooth start. This type of transmission system is accepted by many industries like oil and gas, medical,
aerospace,
mold and die,
and semicon,
because it can machine a wide variety of materials. This technology has been around for over 20 years and has established itself as a reliable system. Cycloidal gears are used in European, high-end Japanese, and American machines like Grob, DMG, and Haas. Its high performance makes it very flexible, allowing you to machine hard materials like titanium, Inconel, and mold steel. Direct servo motor drives. Direct servo motor drives have no transmission. They use servo motors that are directly driven to the rotary table. They have fast indexing speeds and also a 1-to-1 ratio of power because it's directly driven. The system also has zero backlash and is very accurate for 5-axis machining, especially for light cutting, finishing, and machining soft materials. However, it is not suitable for cutting hard materials. It generates less power, which can cause vibrations and chattering marks on your workpiece. The max table load is low, and it's not suitable for heavy or large workpieces. It is mostly used in Japanese and European brands, like Makino and Akuma. Fanuc is also one of the world's best producers of direct servo motor drives. They are mostly used for high volume production of small workpieces, usually used to machine small mold inserts, impellers, and smartphone and camera parts. Worm gears. Worm gears are a very traditional transmission system and cannot meet modern precision machining standards. Its gear ratios give it a very rough start. It generates a lot of friction and gives it slow indexing speeds. This causes wear and tear over time, which will increase backlash. It is mostly used in budget brands, Chinese and Taiwanese machines, and 4th and 5th axis attachments for 3-axis standard machines. This type of transmission system is still okay for general part machining, but is not suitable for precision machining or 5-axis simultaneous machining. The key performance criteria for rotary tables are power, accuracy, and speed. These will help you machine your workpieces accurately and efficiently, even on hard materials. As you can see on the table shown, different rotary transmission systems have their own strengths and weaknesses. You should know from your supplier what type of rotary transmission system your 5-axis machine has, now that you know what performance you can expect. Smart decision makers need to make the choice that is most flexible, that they can use to accept many different types of jobs and more business opportunities. Remember that 5-axis machines are an investment for the long term. Thanks for watching.